Morning. I am Rajiv Kumar, Associate Professor in Department of Physics, SKIT, Jaipur. So today's topic of discussion, helium neon laser. So today we discuss first laser device, helium neon laser. So helium neon laser, it was the first gas laser to be operated successfully and was fabricated by Ali Zawan and his co-workers in 1961. So helium neon laser is first gas laser and it was fabricated in 1961. This is a low power laser and it is used in laboratory purpose for performing experiment based on laser. It has four level laser system. So there are four level which are utilized to produce laser action. Now, as we know, in the component of laser system, there are basically three components. First component, laser active medium. And here we use helium neon gas act as a laser active medium. Laser active medium, those medium which contains metastable state. So helium and neon atoms contains metastable states. Second condition, we need population inversion. To achieve the population inversion, we use pumping source, some energy source. Here we use electric discharge as a pumping source, a very high voltage radio frequency field to produce population inversion. Third one, optical resonator. Third point, to increase the energy density, the number of photons in active medium, we use optical resonator. An optical resonator, as we know from the previous lecture, an arrangement of two plane mirror. So optical resonator is an arrangement of a pair of two plane mirrors. So first we discuss the construction part, next we discuss working or the theory part. So construction part. So helium neon laser is consist of a long narrow discharging tube of diameter is of the order of 1 centimeter and length is the order of nearly 80 centimeter. And this tube is filled with laser active medium. Here we use helium neon gas in the ratio of 10:1. This ratio is most important in laser action. Helium with 10 and neon is 1 atom. Next, this arrangement is placed between two mirrors. So these two mirrors behave as optical resonator. One is 100% reflector and other one is partially reflector. So the photon which are produced by these laser active medium are confined between these two mirrors, which behave as optical resonator. And the separation between these two mirrors should be equal to n lambda by 2. N is some integer, lambda is the wavelength of laser. And here the output wavelength is 6328 angstrom. Next one, we have pumping source. For pumping source, here we use two electrode. To electrode, we use very high voltage, nearly 6000 volt radio frequency field between anode and cathode. So this acts as electrical discharging. Now I read all these points. Helium neon laser consists of a long narrow discharging tube of diameter of about 1 centimeter and length of about 80 centimeter. It consists of a mixture of helium and neon gas in the ratio of 10:1. We will discuss why we use this ratio. This gas mixture of helium and neon gas form active laser medium. Now, this laser active medium or gas system is enclosed between a pair of plane mirrors so that an optical resonator system is formed. One of them is highly reflective, 100% reflector, and another one is partially reflective, partially reflector. The spacing between two plane mirrors should be equal to integral multiple of half wavelength of laser light. This is the condition. Next one is a pumping source, and as a pumping source we use an electric discharge, nearly 6000 volt is used as a pumping source. Electric discharge is produced in the gas mixture by the electrode. Outside the tube is connected to a source of high frequency alternating current. This behaves as a source of energy, which is used to produce population inversion. One, the threshold condition for laser action. So this is the construction part of helium neon laser. The next part is working. Next part is working. Theory or working. So as we know, light emission is a microscopic process. Light is emitted by de-excitation of atom. So we discuss first energy level diagram of helium and neon gas. This is most important. So here we draw energy level diagram. So this represents the ground state. The ground state of helium atom and this one for neon atom. The energy level of helium we represent by symbol F, F1, F2, F3. And the energy level of neon we represent by E1, E2, E3 and so on, E6. Now, helium consists of F1 is the ground state, F2, F3 level are excited state of helium atom and both are metastable state. M stands for metastable state and lifetime of these state is the order of millisecond. So helium atom stay here for a longer time as compared to ordinary excited state. Now for neon atoms, this is E1 is the ground state of neon, then E2, E3, E4, E5, E6. These are the excited state of neon atoms. And E6 and E4 both are metastable state. So neon stay here for a longer time as compared to the ordinary excited energy state. Now what's happened? Now as we apply very high voltage between these two, so the helium neon gas near to electrode surface, ionized, and this forms electron plus ion. तो जो helium neon gas electrode के पास में है, this is ionized, and due to ionize this produce electron ion pair. So first step is near electrode due to very high electric field near the electrode, gas, a mixture of helium and neon becomes ionized and produce electron and ion pairs. Now, as we apply high electric field, so these electrons are accelerated by electric field. So their kinetic energy is increased very rapidly. And these electrons are collide with heliums and neon atoms because tube is filled with helium and neon. But the possibility of collision with helium is more because number of atom of helium 10 as compared to neon atom only 1. So due to collision, electron transfer its energy to helium atom as electron, due to electron helium collision, electron gain, helium gain energy, and they jump into excited state F2 and F3. So helium gain energy and jump into F2 level and F3 level, and both are the metastable energy states. Now, so first process, electron collide with helium. Helium jump into higher state. This star represents helium in excited energy state, F2 or F3. Now what's happened? Now some of these helium atoms, which are in F2 and F3 level, they collide with neon atoms, which are in the ground state. So due to energy transfer through atomic collision, neon atoms gain energy and they jump directly from the ground state to E4 level or E6 level, and the corresponding helium atom comes into the ground state. Because helium stay here for longer time because of helium atom in the metastable state, so there is more probability that they collide with neon and neon atom gain energy, and they directly jump into E4 and E6 level, and both energy level are metastable energy state of neon atoms. So next possibility, helium in the excited state F2, they collide with neon, so helium come into the ground state, there is no star, and neon jump into one of its excited state E4. Similar, helium in F3 level, they collide with neon, due to energy transfer, helium come into the ground state and neon jump into E6 excited energy state. Now, as we know, because of longer lifetime of the metastable state, this process of energy transfer continuously, so we get the condition of population inversion. Lagatar collision hota rahega, aur neon atom directly E1 se E4 aur E6 mein transfer hota rahenge, to E6 aur E4 energy level ki population apne near neighbor E5, E6 ki andar number of population, number of atoms E5 se bahut zyada ho jayenge. Same E4 mein number of neon atom E3 ke comparison mein bahut zyada ho jayenge. Number of atom in E6 and E4 level are much greater than the number of atom in E5, E3 and the ground state. So we achieve the condition of population inversion. Basically, kya hua? We helium atom F2 or F3 level mein the. Yahan par unka lifetime zyada hai. They are collided with neon atom. So neon jump into directly E4 and E6. Both are metastable state. So in this way we achieve the condition of population inversion. N2 is much greater than N1. Now what's happened? What is the role of helium atom? Now we listen. The role of helium atom, the purpose of helium atom is to help to achieve a condition of population inversion in the neon atom. हीलियम का रोल केवल एक ही है, नियोन एटम में पॉपुलेशन इन्वर्जन को क्रिएट करना. नाउ व्हेन द नंबर ऑफ एटम्स इज हियर लार्जर देन विद कंपेयर टू E5 एंड E3 लेवल, नाउ व्हाट्स हैपन, नियोन एटम लूज एनर्जी एंड दे जंप इनटू लोअर स्टेट. सो देयर आर थ्री ट्रांजिशन, वन इज E6 टू E5, नेक्स्ट वन इज E4 टू E3, वन इज E6 टू E3 लेवल. There are three transitions by spontaneously emitted photons, and these photons can trigger the laser action. One is E6 to E5 level. This emit a wavelength 33900 angstrom. This occur in infrared region. Next transition, E4 to E3, and this one is the corresponding wavelength 11500 angstrom, again infrared region. But E6 to E3, this is most important This emit a wavelength of 6 to 8 angstrom red light in visible region. So we wish to confine these photons because these are in visible region. So the photons of wavelength 6 to 8 angstrom in red portion of visible light, the traveling parallel to the axis, bounce back and forth between two N mirrors. तो ये जो photons है, ये अब optical resonator जो हमारा ये जो है, इसके अंदर इन मिरर के बीच में लगातार back and forth motion करता रहेगा. Photon इधर जाएगा, यहाँ से वो reflect होके वापस इधर जाएगा, यहाँ से reflect होके वापस उसी medium में move करता रहेगा. और ये अपने बीच में आने वाले वो सभी neon atom जो कि E6 level में है, वो सभी neon atom जो कि E6 level में है, उन्हें force करेगा the jump into E3 state and emit more and more photons. So stimulated emissions dominate. Now, the excited neon atom jump from E3 to E2 level spontaneously by emitting a photon of lambda 6000 angstrom. So as this occur, so now these photons, now these atoms are again de-excite by spontaneous process and emit a wavelength of 6000 angstrom. And finally, they jump into the lower state, de-excitation by the collision of these neon atom by the wall of the discharging tube. The discharging tube ki jo diwaare hain unse wo collide karega and finally comes into the ground state. The most important part hai wo hai role hai wo hai helium atom ka. Helium atom neon mein population inversion create karega. Number 2, light emission process mein jo contribution hai wo neon ka hai. Light contribution हीलियम नहीं देगा, हीलियम केवल नियोन में पॉपुलेशन इन्वर्जन क्रिएट करेगा एंड दिस वन इज द रिक्वायर्ड कंडीशन फॉर लेजर एक्शन. दिस वन इज द बेसिक वर्किंग ऑफ हीलियम नियोन लेजर एंड हीलियम नियोन लेजर इज ए लो पावर लेजर व्हिच इज यूज्ड इन लेबोरेटरी पर्पस. मैक्सिमम यूज इन लेबोरेटरी पर्पस. सो थैंक्स फॉर